Not all of us may like the way that our body looks, but all of us do care about our bodies. And to be truthful, they are pretty much the most important thing that we have. All the parts in the body that we have a well-defined function that we need them to perform well. But then there are some things which do not really make much sense and can be done away with. Here's a look at some of the useless parts in our body. Number 17. Palmaris Longus Muscles. In the early age of humans, there was a lot of climbing that we had to do. After all, we weren't the strongest or the fastest, so we had to take shelter where most animals would not reach. So there was a muscle that was long and narrow which existed somewhere between the elbows and the wrists to give us that extra strength to climb. But since that is no longer required unless you are a thief with a fancy for high-rises, it is kind of a redundant muscle. And if there was any proof needed, 14% of humans today do not even have this muscle anymore. To make matters worse, the muscle palpates, leading medical students often confusing it with a nerve and giving it wrong diagnosis. Number 16. The plantaris muscle. Since 9% of human beings are being born without this muscle naturally, it is pretty safe to assume that this particular muscle is of no use to us. At least not anymore. The plantaris muscle exists in our feet, from somewhere around the heel to the middle of the foot. The purpose of this muscle is to help us grab things with our feet. Or more specifically, like how monkeys are hanging from trees with their legs? We used to do that. But since we don't anymore, the plantaris muscle can really be done without. Number 15. Coccyx. The human vertebrae is very important. It basically holds us together and helps us move. But there is a part of the vertebrae which serves no purpose. It is the coccyx, and is the last part of the human vertebrae. Its main purpose was to hold the tail when we were evolving. But since the tail is no longer there, we don't really have a reason for the coccyx to exist. Not to mention that in some humans, they tend to grow out, causing these men and women to have a vestigial tail, which is actually pretty embarrassing. Number 14. Plica Semilunaris. While the name may sound like it is something extremely important and complex, it simply refers to the third eyelid. That's right, all of us have a third eyelid. It can be seen when you pull up both of your eyelids at the corner. It mostly produces the crystal type stuff that you get in your eyes after you wake up and has no real reason for existing. Number 13, Arrector Pili. Have you ever had goosebumps? The cause for that is the Arrector Pili, which is basically a muscle that is attached to the hair follicles in your body. And when this muscle contracts, the hair stands on its ends, causing goosebumps. And while the Arrector Pili does serve a function in animals to communicate when they are pissed to each other, humans have no real reason for this muscle. Number 12. Wisdom Teeth. In the old ages, when humans were eating a lot of tough meats, which at the time were uncooked, the wisdom teeth played a role in helping us chew them. But since we hardly ever eat raw meat anymore, there is no real purpose for the wisdom teeth. Except, of course, causing an immense amount of pain and irritation when they happen to grow skewed. In fact, in a lot of people, they don't really bother coming out either. It's not a loss, really, as we don't really ever use them. Number 11. Tonsils. Many of us dread the thought of tonsils. They're basically lymphoid tissue that tends to get infected a lot. And when they do, they cause a lot of pain. Considering that it serves no real purpose, having a tonsil does not make sense. That is why doctors have no hesitation in removing them whenever it gets infected. But removing it is also pretty painful, as it requires the administration of penicillin, which is an already pretty painful injection. Number 10. Adenoids. Okay, so this might not exactly be as useless as we might think. At least, not for kids anyway. Adenoids are basically masses of lymphoid tissue that are located at the back of the nose, and when we are kids, they help us trap the bacteria. But since very few bacteria are airborne, there is not much use, and in any case, they tend to shrink and lose their function as we grow. So all in all, they are not really very useful. Number 9. Sinuses. These are another extremely irritating body part that tend to give us a lot of headaches. Sinuses are basically air pockets that exist in our skull. Some believe that they insulate our eyes, and others believe they are responsible for the tonal quality of our voice. Whatever the reason may be, they are generally known for giving us killer headaches, and some of us would say that we are better off without it. But then, doctors and scientists have not really been able to figure out what they are actually for, so it might not really be a good idea to remove them. Number 8. Subclavius Muscle. Another muscle that we do not need anymore is the subclavius muscle. It is actually a small, thick, triangular tendon that stretches between the first rib and the collarbone. The purpose of this muscle was to help us walk when we used to walk on four limbs. But since evolution has kind of eliminated that style of walking in humans completely, this is a useless muscle that we just carry around. Perhaps this is why that many of us are born without it these days. Number 7. Appendix. This is an organ which would actually be one of those most loved organs by doctors. After all, they have no purpose in our bodies and are pretty easy to remove. And they tend to cause a lot of abdominal pain when it becomes swollen, so many people have to get their appendix removed. It is basically a small pouch-like structure between the large and small intestine, and was useful only when primitive humans were gatherers and it helped them in digesting all those rough vegetables. Number 6. Body hair. While there is no doubt that hair is important, especially the ones on the head as they provide protection and insulation, body hair is actually a turnoff and something that we could do without. They have no apparent function and they are not really thick enough in most cases to provide the heat that they do in animals, which is why many men decide to get rid of it. And while body hair is generally not that much of a problem in females, they too remove it as soon as they sight any of it. Number 5. Auricular Muscle. Well, okay, if pleasing kids with little tricks is what you do, then you might need this muscle. But since that is not something most of us do, the auricular muscle is not really needed in the body. It is actually the muscle around the outer ear, and those who can control it can wiggle their ears. Animals like rabbits and dogs also have these muscles, which is why they are able to turn their ears wherever they want. But humans do not have that degree of control over it, and in fact, many of us can't actually use it at all. That is why ear wigglers are not really that common. Number 4. Philtrum. Okay, so this is something that we actually have a use for, but only when we are in the womb. The philtrum is basically the groove between your nose and mouth. While we are pretty sure that not many of us have ever wondered about it, the fact is that there is no reason for it to exist once we are born. The philtrum is the place where the face connects in the womb. The indentation is necessary if your face has to develop properly. But then, sometimes it does not and leads to cleft lips. So while it is necessary during the womb, outside, it has no purpose. But since it is just an indentation and not really a structure, we're not sure if it can be removed. But it is definitely not needed. Number 3. Darwin's Point. Well, the name should make it pretty clear that evolution would definitely have something to do with it. Darwin's point is actually a small, folded skin that is present towards the top of the ear. It is believed that it is a remnant from earlier times when our ears were shaped differently. The purpose was so that we could hear distant sounds better and be alerted to any danger. Nowadays, we just install an intruder alarm for that. Or keep a dog. Number 2. Female Vas Deferens. It is believed that men and women start out the same in the womb. And so, there are some tubes in men, called the vas deferens, which are responsible for carrying the sperm. But as fetuses, even females have these tubes which kind of linger around even when they are fully grown. But these tubes have no purpose to serve in females. And true to that, they are just tubes which go nowhere and are just floating about. Number 1. The male nipples. When we say that men and women start off the same in the womb, we actually mean that we all start out as females. And as we know how important nipples are, at least in females, they develop at a pretty early stage before the genitals. Hence, all of us have nipples. But while females have a pretty important use for them when they grow up, men have no real use for it. While there have been cases of men lactating, it is never healthy to feed it to a baby. And to tell you the truth, the baby might have a hard time trying to squeeze men's nipples considering that the breast is not present. Of course, there are some cases of male boobs as well, but it is extremely rare for men to lactate and have boobs. So all in all, male nipples are something we can definitely do without. Have you ever faced a problem with any of these body parts? Or have you ever had them removed? Tell us what your experiences were in the comments section below. And do remember to subscribe to our channel to get updates on all of our videos.